All right, here we go. So to do a BWA box run, you will want to most likely use a class like the Tiger Claw, something very fast.
Getting lots of turbulence up here. I've never seen melding quite like this.
We're almost there.
Damn it, we lost our left rear actuator. We're going down. Brace for impact.
3-5? Boss, do you read me? There you are. Thank God. You've been out for a few hours.
Laramie was working. Now, we aren't going for a completion of BWA. We're just trying to grab boxes. So as you can see here, we're going to follow this path. We're going to grab all these boxes.
Just focus on finding any surviving Devilhawks.
And then we're going to exit.
Power up both generators.
We're starting with 163,606 Christite.
Damn it. Hold on. We've got Chosen zeroing in on you. You need to eliminate those bastards before I send in the repulsor.
So for the first part, you just need to kill the enemies as quickly as you can. This is going worse than it usually does for me, because I have to play in windowed mode. For some reason, my recording wasn't working in full screen. As such, my frame rate is somewhere around the 20s. And we got our first module! Okay, we're gonna start on our first box. So we just gotta wait for the melding to push back.
Okay, I think I've got three rough area signatures ahead of me, but something's distorting the exact coordinates. Marking the distortions on your map.
Now, the nice thing about the Tiger Claw is that you got Trailblaze and Afterburner, which lets you move very quickly. So we're not really going to be focusing on fighting the Chosen. We're going to be looking around to grab the boxes. Now, I play in third person for this part because a lot of the times the boxes will spawn items, you know, on top of the cliffs or up in the ceiling or so, and you don't want to miss those. And, you know, if you can do it in first person, that's fine. It's just, it's easier for me. Now, I also use the Xeer's Loot Tracker mod, as you can see in the chat. And that's also very important, because it'll show you where everything is. Now, sometimes inside that specific dropship, it will spawn something in the ceiling that you can't get, and unfortunately, that can sometimes happen.
Oh my God. What the hell is that?
But we're going through, we're grabbing all the rare crates. As you can see, we got some iron there. Now, you can usually get between 500 to 1,000 iron ore per run. You know, it's just all very random what you get. Sometimes you can get a whole bunch of items. Sometimes you can get a whole bunch of, you know, resources. I've gotten tungsten here before. Let's see if you didn't want to miss that. The main thing, though, is to not miss the little boxes. I checked up there because sometimes it can spawn them, you know, Christite on top of that cliff.
Looking at the interference in that area, I'm guessing there's another one of those.
Now, one of the things they also will do is, if there's a Siegebreaker or a Juggernaut nearby, I'll usually shoot them because they have a pretty good chance of dropping a lot of Christite. Because normally, just like the normal Chosen, they're going to drop like 2 or 3 Christite, and that's just not worth it. But sometimes you can get the Juggernauts and the Siegebreakers to drop around 40. Yeah, I won't go out of my way to try and seek them out, but if they're there, you know, take him down. See? Yep, here we go. A level 2 gun. Yeah, all these boxes are level 2, so if they drop any items, they're all going to be level 2. Yeah, that's, you know, a very long journey to the next box. That's why I want to at least save some afterburner charges and stuff to make that journey quicker. So we're heading down to the final 3 locations now. Now this box is annoying because it often will spawn things inside the ship. And great, it didn't spawn anything in there. Now that rare crate, it will often spawn things up inside of the tree, so you gotta watch out for that. So we didn't. Alright, it didn't spawn anything this time, but it happens a lot. And then for the final 2. There we go. Now we just leave the zone. And then while we're waiting for it to count down, we'll just go kill some more stuff. Usually some juggernauts and stuff over here that can give you good drops. Okay, now we're going to salvage and refine, see what we got. So I'm going to get rid, you know, salvage the 2 things that we got, you know, the level 2 gun, And there's the 25 module. And then we have to go all the way down to the very bottom. And we got the circuit salvage and our junk salvage. And you get a variable number amount of this stuff. And so, you know, the actual amount of money you earn per run can change. So we got a pretty good amount that time. Now, we didn't get much iron ore this time. Sometimes, you know, I've been able to get like 1,000 iron ore and 500 tungsten. But we are getting a lot of chitin fibers this run. So we're getting 20 carbon powder. And 34 chitin fibers. And that run took pretty much 10 minutes exactly. They can usually go quicker, but I was running at a low frame rate, so I wasn't that accurate. But here we go, our final total, 170,611 Christite. And so that means that we earned 7,000 Christite. So in 10 minutes, we earned 7,000 Christite. And if you notice, I don't have any of the bonuses. So if we had, you know, the daily, we would earn an extra 10%. And with VIP, an extra 25%. So with VIP and daily, we would have been getting over 9,000 Christite per run. And so you only need 4 runs if you, you know, without VIP and 3 runs with VIP. And so there we go. I hope you enjoyed.